Alright, hey guys, we're here at the Bristol Bash. Last night, Brandon Shepherd was quickest in practice, so I think he's probably going to end up winning, but I really
hope not.
Yeah, that's true. Ricky Thornton Jr., he wrecked really hard last night, apparently. I didn't see the video or anything. Did you see the video?
No, I know they tore up a couple cars last night.
Oh, there was a couple?
Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy. I'll keep you posted on everything at Bristol.
Now start to pick up the pace, and here we go. Hot lap session number two.
I just wanted to recap on what happened Friday night. I guess I can't really say nothing big didn't happen. Strickler set a new track record, I believe, right? 127 miles per hour, something like that. Sadly, he was light over the scales in the heat race, and then was getting lapped, and then that wreck happened with Jimmy Owens' tire coming off, as you kind of saw in the video. Richards ended up winning. I thought Chris Madden was going to get him. I don't know if you thought he was going to get him or not.
No.
You didn't think he was getting him?
No.
Even with the green flag out?
Yeah, it was green flag, but I didn't know he was gone.
Oh, boy. There were a lot of wheels breaking throughout the night. Jimmy Owens' left rear coming off and Strickler hitting that. Then you had, you said the left rear or the right? You said left rear. The modified came off and went from turn three and four all the way down to turn one, basically. And you should have heard the crowd when they went past this flag stand. But everything was actually really exciting. It looked empty, but it was actually really packed from parking wise. It seemed like it was packed for,
yeah, if you looked up behind us, it was pretty full. It's just with so many seats, it's,
yeah,
makes it look deceiving.
Yeah, but there was a lot of braking. There was a lot of people that getting hard hits and stuff like that, but I mean, that's racing, they always have hard hits and stuff like that. So it was dusty, but I kind of expected it to be a little bit more dustier than it was, so I give props to Bristol for doing the track prep. And it actually had two lanes, because Overton had a run from 10th to 5th within the last three laps, which was actually pretty impressive. So there was kind of a top, but there really wasn't. It just kind of went both ways. But I don't know if they... Do they still want rain tomorrow?
It's down to like a 50% chance of showers.
Really? All right, so we might be at Bristol tomorrow. If not, maybe we can go to Port Royal.
I doubt it.
But I think we're going to try to do some tourist stuff in the morning if we wake up on time. If we decide not to, then we're probably just going to go to Cracker Barrel and just sit around and wait for the races to start. Are we going there early tomorrow?
If we get up early.
Okay.
I'm not setting an alarm.
I'm
not setting an alarm.
I'm not setting an alarm either. Yeah, so second night of the trip, great. I'll be taking more videos and stuff like that for tomorrow and keeping you guys updated for tomorrow, so I'll see you then. Hey guys, this is the second day overall, I should say. We're about to head to Bass Pro Shops. We kind of woke up late this morning to sleep in, it's supposed to rain. I think it's 80% chances of rain, right?
Yeah, around 5 o'clock.
Yeah, right around the time that it's supposed to race. So we're gonna go to Bass Pro Shops, waste a couple hours there looking at that stuff that we're probably not even gonna end up buying, and then head over to the track, maybe pick out a couple more shirts or get a couple more good clips of everything that's going on, and then hopefully get some racing in. If not, we're gonna end up just heading home. I don't think we're gonna be able to make Hagerstown or anything like
that. We would have to leave about now.
And Port Royal moved theirs up, so we probably would miss Port Royal and Paps. So hopefully we can get this race in. Last night it was pretty cool watching all the cars fly around the track and stuff like that. I was really interested to see if Strickler would pull something out of his hat for tonight. I don't know, probably not. Everybody was pretty much packed up last night and ready to go home. but yeah, so I'll keep y'all updated. The race today was canceled because of the rain. We thought we might have been able to squeeze it in, but the track was just way too tacky and wet for the late models to go there. And I mean, they would have been probably hitting way above what they were hitting last night, which is crazy because a lot of the wheels were breaking off last night just because of the speeds and stuff like that. So it would have been cool to see them again tonight and battling for $25,000 to win, right? Yeah. $25,000 to win, but I mean, it's always driver safety over everything, so I understand with that. But the weekend was great. We had a lot of fun coming down here, checking out Bristol, and this is my first time in Tennessee, so checking out Tennessee and seeing some World of Outlaw late models, seeing some modifieds and stuff like that, so that was pretty cool. They did reschedule the race for noon tomorrow, but we won't be able to stick around because of the 600 needing maintenance and getting it all ready and checking their front end from the race on Wednesday. So, and also because of our work schedule, we won't be able to stay another night. So we're gonna head back tomorrow, and I'll be getting ready for Wednesday and probably studying my head off to try to get better. And we'll have a new video up with me at Shell Hammers. I think Ross will be bringing in another in his GoPro, so we'll have two GoPros on the car, so that would be pretty cool to see two different angles of the car. And I believe I might be going to BAPS, so there might be another two videos coming out next week also. At least one just from Shell Hammers, but there might be another one from BAPS. I just wanted to take a minute to thank all of our sponsors. You got Bowman Renovation, that's right behind me here. J&M Flooring, Arner's Furniture, TSL Shocks, HRE, Hyper, Tops Up Here Bud, and CPG Graphics. We also got SDS Photography, always taking amazing photos of us and everybody else. Without them, it wouldn't really be possible for me to do what I love, so big shout out to them. If you guys have any in touch or contact with Cheez-Its, we're trying to get a Cheez-Its sponsorship for a couple races, but I hope that happens, but we'll never know. So we'll have the new video coming from Wednesday, and like I said, there will be two in-car cameras, so let us know what you think we should put the cameras, if we should put it facing me, or put it one camera where it was last week, and or one going out the back showing like the rear of the car and stuff like that. So let us know, and see you guys next week.